In this video, I'm going to go over the process I used to create the muscles on this guy. So let's get started in Mudbox. I've got a low-res base mesh, and I'm going to get some texture reference of a muscular guy, and I want to project it onto my model as a stencil. And the first thing I'm going to do is go to the Edit Stencil option, and I'm going to change the stencil around so that it matches my model more carefully. And to edit the stencil, I can use both painting tools and sculpting tools. So I'm going to use the grab brush to just push the image reference around so that it matches my model more closely. And then I'll project it using the projection brush, and now I'm ready to start sculpting. So I've created a sculpt layer, and I'm going to try using the sculpt brush first, but creating muscle shapes with the sculpt brush can be difficult, so I like to use the wax brush instead. And with the wax brush, I'll lay in big areas of muscle mass, and in general, I'll try and mimic the shape of the actual muscle fibers and the direction that the muscles flow in with individual strokes from the wax brush. I'll continue this all across the front of the characters so that I've created as much muscle detail as I can that's visible from my front view projection. And once I've got that blocked in, I want to turn the texture off so that I can view the sculpt detail without the texture. And I'll see that I have this obviously very blocky shape. So I want to take the smooth brush and just smooth those muscle shapes together. And creating this way mimics the way the actual body works, where we have these big muscle shapes that are covered underneath skin. And so the skin is almost like a fabric that's stretched over these big shapes that kind of mutes the individual silhouette of each object, and it makes them all blend together. So we end up with this, and now we're going to turn our attention to the back. I've already projected the texture, and I'm just going to use the wax brush again to block out the shape and then smooth it out as I did with the front. Next, I'm going to reduce the opacity of my textures to 50%. And this means that I can see more of my sculpt detail and less of my texture detail. It's time to up-res our mesh to subdivide again. And we want to test our brushes to make sure that we can get the level of detail we need. We're looking for brushes that don't have a lot of aliasing around them when we use them on the mesh. The next step is carving detail into the surface using a brush that has a very sharp fall off and a negative value. And I'll just push in around the larger shapes to better define the edges of those shapes. So I'm using this sharp negative brush to carve around muscle edges and bone edges to really emphasize that sharper level of detail. I can also add more detail using the wax brush at this level. And in both cases, whether I'm adding mass using wax or carving in using that sharp negative brush, I'm always smoothing right after I paint that detail in to better blend everything together to make it look like a more organic form. You'll note that I'm sculpting asymmetrically. This is because most bodies are asymmetrical, but especially the front of the torso, this is very important, because that's generally where the viewer is going to notice it most. In the case of the pectorals and the abdominals on a character like this, we really want to make sure that we're creating asymmetrical shapes, and we really want to pay attention to our reference as opposed to trying to create shapes the way we think they should be instead of the way they actually are. I'll add the belly button while I'm here. I'm using a sharp positive brush to just kind of stretch it between the existing abdominals. It doesn't pop out or sit on top of the abdominal region. And as always, to check my sculpting, I'm turning the texture off so I can see the actual surface detail that I've created. And then I'll just repeat this smoothing process on the back. One thing that I noticed as I was sculpting is that the muscles on the back really didn't have enough volume. Things weren't popping out enough. So I tried to use the wax brush and the sculpt brush to try and push things out. But for existing detail that's already well-defined, the bulge tool will inflate the existing detail, and it's really great for popping muscles out. Now, still working with the back, I'm making sure that all my shapes are very smoothly blended together, so I have a cohesive, organic-feeling body. And then I can step up to a higher subdivision level and start to add finer detail the way that I did on the front of the torso, where I'm pushing smaller details out, and I'm also using that sharp negative brush to carve detail in around shapes. Now, the bigger the area that I'm carving into, the bigger I want my sharp brush to be, because I want to create some roundness along the edges of the area that I'm carving into. So in areas where you have big muscles or areas like the center of the spine, we're using a much bigger brush than we might expect because we want to have nice rounded shapes so that they look like muscles, as opposed to creating really thin lines between our shapes, which kind of looks like a comic book drawing. It takes on a fake kind of artificial look. And after I've carved in all that detail, I'll go through and I'll smooth a lot of it out. And this may seem counterproductive, but again, this is the way that the body works. We have these very defined muscle and bone shapes, and the skin is laid over them. The skin stretches on top, and it creates a much smoother surface. Once I'm done there, I'm going to subdivide again because I want to add even finer resolution detail. And at this point, now I can represent very detailed things like striations in the muscle and more unique organic forms. I stressed earlier that we don't want to have a symmetrical shape, so now is the time when we start carving in asymmetrical detail around our muscle shapes using that sharp negative brush. I've also mentioned a few times how the skin stretches over top of objects, and we've used the smooth brush to accomplish that up till now. We can also use the fill brush. When we have a pretty big gap between areas, we can use that fill brush to stretch between those areas, and that'll actually create a very stretched look that we can then blend into the surface. And we do that when we're looking for a guy who looks really ripped, whose muscles are basically too big for the skin that they're covered with. It creates that really hyper-muscular look. At this level of detail, I'll also use my sculpt and my wax brushes to add tiny bulges along the surface. This helps things look more organic, more like a natural shape, and it kind of reflects the fact that each individual's body is going to have differences between the way their muscles are formed and the way that they're used. And I can stretch between those details using the fill brush to enhance that stretched look again. So we haven't looked at the front in a while. I'll turn my attention back here, and I'll start to carve in those same sorts of high-level detail where I'm using my sharp negative brush to just add some difference in definition between muscle groups, for example, between the pectoral and the deltoids here. And at the same time, I'll smooth other bits of detail, for example, the area where the abdominals connect to the rib cage. We're usually not going to see a tremendously sharp line there unless we have someone that's flexing very hard. So I'll just smooth that out so we get better blend. And depending on the kind of character that we're trying to create, we might want to have exactly that kind of super sharp hypermuscular detail. At this point, I just noticed that the clavicle is sticking out a little bit too much, so I use my grab brush to push that back in. And now we're ready for our next step. I'm going to subdivide again and just test to make sure that the level of resolution is what I need. And I'm going to use my pinch brush now. And I'll drag the pinch brush around all the edges that usually we've been using our sharp negative brush to define. And this pinch brush will pull all that detail together and create much higher frequency detail. The end result is going to be sharper or more crisp detail. And this is a really important aspect of the sculpting process because, by default, our sculpt tools give us very naturally soft shapes. And this is where the pinch brush comes into play. It pulls those shapes together. It creates sharper creases between objects. And this is definitely a big step that separates professional and amateur models. It's very easy to create a soft, blobby model. Knowing how to sharpen it, how to pull those shapes together, is what pushes the model to the next level. Now, once again, seemingly counterproductively, I'm again softening my detail using the smooth tool, and I'm smoothing around the pinches that I created to blend the pinches into the surrounding areas. What I'm not smoothing is the sharp line at the center of each pinch. So this way we get a nice, smooth, organic model. but at the same time, we still retain a lot of that sharp detail. And this is as far as I'm going to take it with this tutorial. We've laid in our basic shapes. We've carved in some sharper detail, blended everything together nicely with smooths. We've used pinch to sharpen things up. And this process is a quick one. It took less than an hour to create this muscle detail because it's a quick and intuitive way to work. Thanks for watching. I hope that you found this helpful. You can check out methodj.com for more.